Yeah, we'll start with a new section. Give the heading. Section 44 ADA. Section 44 ADA. See, one of first prism to section that we have seen is what, sir?
44 AD.
That is for which whom? For those people who are into business. Business jo karte hain unke liye hai. This section is meant for those people who are into profession, right now? Shall we start? You don't write, just listen. Applicability. This section is applicable to any person. Unlike saying that it is applicable for individual, this section is applicable to any person. Maybe resident, maybe what, sir? Non-resident. Right. They should be engaged in what, you know? They should be engaged in profession. Which type of profession? Profession of legal. Like law ka profession hai. Medical hai, right now? Yes, chartered accountancy, etc. And look, any type of profession if you are doing, whose gross receipts should not exceed how much, sir? 50 lakhs. If you are into profession and the gross receipts from profession is not exceeding how much? 50 lakhs. Then yes, you can opt for the section. Now, what is the presumptive income? Very easy. The presumptive income in this section is very, very high. It is 50% of gross receipts. The government believes that when it compared to business, profession people earn a lot of money as a proportion of their gross receipts. So 50% of your gross receipts is taken as what, sir? Presumptive income. Just for an example, sake, example, Mr. X is a chartered accountant right now. His gross receipts from CA practice, his gross receipts from CA practice is coming around 40 lakhs. Now government what will assume? The presumptive income is how much, sir? 50% of 40 lakhs. Therefore, presumptive income is how much, sir? 20 lakhs. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, last point. Most of the points that you have learned in which section? That you have learned in 44 AD will almost apply to what, sir? 44 ADA. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Don't worry. All those points I'll repeat in the notes. Shall we start the notes?
Yes, sir.
Are you clear with this section?
Yes, sir.
Please start. Start karo. Point number one. Oh, did not you write the heading?
Yes.
Heading right leda. Okay. 44 ADA- presumptive income. Presumptive income in case of. Presumptive income in case of. SSEs. Presumptive income in case of SSEs engaged in. Engaged in eligible profession. Engaged in eligible profession. Underline karke likho. Start. Point number one. Applicability. Applicability. Any SSC. Applicability. Any SSC. Koi bhi chalta hai. Point number B. The SSC should be. Engaged. The SSC should be engaged in profession as referred in section 44 AA. Section 44 AA. Actually 44 AA talks about what's the books of accounts. Wahan pe for books they have given a definition of profession. That is legal, comma medical, comma engineering, comma architect, comma accountancy, comma technical consultancy, or interior decorator. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Next. These are the examples of profession. Next, point number three. The presumptive income would be 50% of gross receipts. I think I forgot to tell you the limit right in the notes.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
The presumptive income would be 50% of gross receipts. Can you come to the previous point again? Bracket may write the limit in the previous point. Otherwise, shall I write, make it a separate point?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, point number four. Section will apply only if the gross receipts from profession do not exceed the gross receipts from profession does not exceed 50 lakhs. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
So principal, you may be any SSE, you are into excise of profession, whose receipts does not exceed how much, sir? 50 lakhs. If you observe the word, does not exceed, that equal to symbol is also there. Okay, the presumed income is how much, sir? Very, very high, 50% of gross receipts, right? Now, and most of the point that we have learned in 44 AD will equally apply here. Can we write?
Yes, sir.
Next point, point number five. Most of the points that we have learned in 44 AD will apply here. 44 AD will apply here, which are as follows. Most of the points that we have learned in 44 AD will apply here, which are as follows. Likho aram se. You can write the list. A. All deductions under section 30, TO to 37(1) are deemed to have been allowed, including unabsorbed depreciation. All deductions under section 30 to 37(1) are deemed to have been allowed, including what, sir? Unabsorbed depreciation. Bolo.
Yes, sir.
Next, B. Set off and carry forward of losses are still allowed. Yaad aa raha hai na, same points?
Yes, sir.
C. ATC to ATU deduction can still be claimed. ATC to ATU deductions can still be claimed. Next. Le sakte ho ATC to ATU. Next, point D. Sir, mera hai na? Point D. No books, no audit. If section is complied. Next, point by E. Mandatory books and mandatory audit. If section is not complied, remember na? If section is not complied, and very good. Turnover nahi, total income exceeds. Yeah, and total income exceeds how much, sir? Basic exemption limit. Yaad aa raha hai?
Yes, sir.
Next, point number F. Advance tax only one time. Do you remember? Advance tax only one time. Hyphen. On or before 15th of March. Same. Whatever you have learned in 44 AD, same points. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Boliye na, sir.
Yes, sir.
Right. Point number?
G.
However, this is a different point. However, there is no such condition that, yeah, aisa koi logic nahi. However, there is no such condition that there would be a lock-in period of 5 years. However, there is no such condition that there would be a lock-in period of how many years?
5 years.
There would be a lock-in period of 5 years. Aisa koi condition nahi hai. Am I clear? Everyone clear?
Yes, sir.
Clear? So applicability, any SSE, receipt should not exceed how much, sir? 50 lakhs. Presumed income is how much, sir? 50% of your gross assets. Somewhat really high, sir. Because 50% of gross is like too much income, right? Na? The government should have made around 25 to 30% as presumed income. Okay, still you can claim ATC to AT benefit, you can claim set off and carry forward. All those benefits you can claim, right? Don't forget unabsorbed depreciation. Depreciation and all current year expenses are deemed to have been allowed. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Can we go to the next section?
Yes, sir.
That's it. Very simple section, sir. Any doubts?
No, sir.
Any doubts?
No, sir.
Chalo. Give the next heading. 44AE. I am going to the next section. 44AE. Presumptive income. 44AE. Presumptive income in case of. Presumptive income in case of. In case of SSE engaged in the business of, in case of SSE engaged in the business of plying, 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 leasing,
hiring.
Plying, leasing and hiring of goods carriages. Plying, leasing, hiring of what, sir? Goods carriages. Plying, leasing, hiring of goods carriages.
Sir.
Yeah, don't write. Again, you can have to look at the board. Don't write, please. 44AE. This is an important section, sir. Compared to the first two sections, relatively important for student life. Have a look at the provisions. Applicability wise, this section is applicable to any SSE. When I say any SSE, it may be any. Koi bhi SSE can comply with this section. You may be resident, non-resident, individual, corporate, non-corporate, sab chalta hai, right na? Okay. What you should do, the SSE should be engaged in what business?
Plying.
You should be engaged in the business of plying,
leasing
or hiring. What, sir?
Hiring.
Hiring of goods carriages, right na?
Carriages.
Goods, goods only. Goods,
carriages.
See, generally goods carriages can be what, sir? It can be generally what, sir? Lorry.
Lorry.
Yes or no?
Trucks.
It also includes autos. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Truck ka matlab hi lorry hai. Autos bhi cover ho jayenge. Matlab imagine I'm in the business of giving Tata Aces on rent. Mera business hai wo. Rent pe deta hu. The government says, you can comply with this section.
Yes,
I am not running the lorry, come on.
Yes,
I got lot of capital, I'm purchasing it. I'm purchasing lorries, giving lorries on rent. Right na? Dekhenge. So applicability, any SSE. What is doing? He should be engaged in the business of applying, leasing and hiring of goods carriages.
Yes,
a small doubt here. Should be exclusive activity? Should this business be an exclusive business? Or can it, this should be a parcel business? Yehi karna hai kya? It should be an exclusive activity or he, along with this he can do something else also? Let you do anything. What we want, SSE should be in the business of plying, leasing and hiring of goods carriages. Plying matlab, you are into transportation.
Yes, sir.
Leasing and hiring matlab, you are giving the vehicles on rent, right na? Careful. So going further. What is a presumptive income? Government says presumptive income is something like this. It's a bit different here. In case of small vehicles, what will be small, sir? Small is a classroom word. Small matlab, the unladen weight of the vehicle should not exceed 12,000 kgs. Or you can simply say 12 tons. If the vehicle weight does not exceed how much, sir? 12,000 kg. Then it can be said as what, sir? Small vehicle. You know what is the presumptive income for small vehicle? Government says the presumptive income would be 7,500 rupees per month per truck. Getting or not, sir?
Yes, sir.
Per month per truck. That's it. If you are observing or not, it is simply per month per truck. It is not put to use. So it should be 7,500 per month per truck. Owned by the SSE, right na, sir?
Yes, sir?
Example, sir. Example, if you have 5 trucks, small trucks I am referring, if you have 5 small trucks for all the 12 months, the presumed income should be 5 trucks into 7,500 per month into 12 months. Can anyone tell me the answer, please? Anyone, please, sir?
50,000.
It should be 4 lakh.
50,000
is the presumptive income. Matlab, example sake. If you are having 5 trucks and you are using these trucks for transportation activity, then what is the presumptive income? The presumptive income from those 5 trucks is assumed to be how much? 4,50,000. You may earn literally 40-50 lakhs also from those 5 trucks. Does not really bother. Government assumes that you are earning how much income? 4,500. Let me go to a big truck. Cheap. 4,50,000. Let me go to a big truck. No, I think you should be able to tell the big truck is nothing but the unladen weight of the vehicle exceeds 12,000 kgs. Do you agree? Yes or no? 12,000 kg. Or you can also say the tonnage capacity is more than what, sir? 12 tons, right? What does the government says? Government says in case of big trucks, we cannot write answer like this. The presumptive income would be simply rupees 1,000. I'll write very clearly. It should be rupees 1,000 per month. Do you agree? Okay. So depending on the tonnage of the vehicle, depending on the size of the weight it can handle, right now, that should be the presumptive income. Let's say you have 4 lorries, right now, whose capacity is 16 tons. Each vehicle weighs how much tons? 16 tons. So how will you compute presumptive income? The presumptive income would be 16 tons into 1000 rupees per month. That's called 16,000 rupees per month. Into how many months? 12 months. Into how many vehicles? 4 vehicles. Can someone tell me the answer?
7 lakhs.
It should be how much?
7 lakhs.
Yeah, please everyone multiply 16 into 1000 into 12 months into 4 trucks. How much?
7 lakhs.
7 lakhs? 68,000 would be a presumptive income. Yeah. It is per ton per month, correct? That does not really bother. Per ton, huh?
Per
tonnage only, na sir? How many tons are there? How many trucks are there? I'm not really bothered. I'm bothered about the number of total tons. You tell me, if one truck is 16 tons, then 4 trucks are total how many tons? 48 tons. 48 tons. So this is like 48 tons into 1000 into 12 months. Am I clear? Are we clear? Therefore, in this example, the total presumptive income from those 5 plus 4 trucks is how much, you know? 4,50,000. Yeah, 4,50,000 plus
7,68,000.
Put together, what is the income?
12,18,000
is assumed to be your income. It's very easy. For small truck, what is the answer? 7,500 rupees per month. Does not really bother tonnage. For big trucks, what is the answer, sir? It is 1,000 rupees per ton per truck. Am I clear? Yeah, please take the notes. Give the heading. 44 ADA. I think already we have given the heading, right? 44 AE. Already heading is given, right? Yeah, please take the notes. Applicability. Applicability. Any SSE. You have to write, sir. Yeah. Applicability, any SSE. Point B. The SSE should be engaged. The SSE should be engaged in the business of. The SSE should be engaged in the business of plying. Chalana, vehicle ko chalana hai na? The SSE should be engaged in the business of plying, comma, leasing. Plying, leasing, or hiring of goods carriages. Plying, comma, leasing, or hiring of goods carriages. Plying, leasing, or hiring of goods carriages. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Next point number 3. The SSE should not own. The SSE should not own. The SSE should not own more than. The SSE should not own more than 10 goods carriages. The SSE should not own more than 10 goods carriages at any point of time. At any point of time during the previous year. The SSE should not own more than 10 goods carriages at any point of time during the previous year. Pure saal mein 10 se zyada nahi. Am I clear? Note number 1. Uske niche note likh do. Note number 1. Note number 1. Owned vehicles also includes leased vehicles. Ye doubt tha na kisi ko? Owned vehicles also includes what, sir? Leased vehicles. Owned vehicles also includes, huh? leased vehicles. Right, very good. Note number two. Note number two. Note number two. At any point of time. Note number two. Akkade raskondi. At any point of time. If owned vehicles plus leased vehicles, if owned vehicles plus leased vehicles exceeds, owned vehicles plus leased vehicles exceeds 10, comma, section 44AE will not apply. Do you agree?
Yes, sir.
Section 44AE will not apply. Super. Next one. Point number 4, if I am not wrong. Note I am completed. Point number 4. Presumptive income. Presumptive income. See, presumptive income is different, right? For small vehicles and big vehicles, you should write differently. Split into two. Split into two. In case of small vehicles. Now, what is small vehicle? The weight does not exceed 12,000 kg or 12 tons, right? Small vehicles. Bracket mein. Unladen weight. Unladen matlab without load. Unladen weight does not exceed 12,000 kgs. Down arrow. Presumptive income is. Down arrow. Presumptive income is 7,500 per month. Per truck. Very good. Haji? Yeah. 7,500 per month per truck. Owned by SSE. Owned vehicles includes leased vehicles. Huh? Imagine 4 are owned by me, 3 are leased by me. Put together you will do computation for how many vehicles? 7. Am I clear? Second side. In case of big vehicles. Right? I think you know the weight should be how much, sir? No? More than 12,000 kg. Down arrow. The presumptive income would be rupees 1000 per ton. Rupees 1000 per ton per month owned by the SSE. Am I clear?
Sir.
Owned by the SSE. Now please write one small note, common note for both the points. Can you write a small note?
Yes, sir.
Note. Month here refers to calendar month. Full stop. If the SSE purchases a truck on 19th June 2019 and sells it on 2nd of July 2019. See, if you observe, hardly is owner for 14-15 days, right? Down arrow. Still presumptive income would be computed for
2 months.
Very good. 2 months. Still presumptive income would be computed for how many months?
2 months.
Everyone clear?
Yes, sir.
Shall we move, Nana?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, clear? Now give the heading other points. See, what main section we have taken care, sir? You may be any SSE. You are in the business of applying, leasing or hiring of goods carriages, right? Now, the presumed income is how much, sir? 7,500 per month per truck. If you are having a small truck. If you are having big trucks, answer is how much, sir? 1,000 per month. 1,000 per ton per month, right? What we'll do, we'll take one example to understand this example. Please write one example. Other points, my first point is example. We'll write one example. That would be better, na? Acha sir, clarity is on me aayega. Example. On 1/4/2019, Mr. X owns 4 small trucks. Mr. X owns 4 small trucks. Okay, very good. On 16th November 2019, Mr. X purchases two big trucks. Tons AK, 16 tons each. Simple. 16 tons each. Okay. Again, on 14th February 2020, Mr. X takes on lease one small truck, hai na?
Yes, sir.
One small truck, that's it. Compute presumptive income under section 44AE. I hope this will clear all the doubts for you, right?
Yes, sir.
Compute presumptive income under section what, sir? 44AE. Shall I?
Yes, sir.
Will you try first?
Yes, sir.
Try 1 minute. You try. Don't see my board. 44AE. Four small trucks. The answer should be 7,500 into 12 months into four trucks for two big trucks. It should be 1,000 rupees into 16 tons into how many months? November, December, January, February, March. 5 months. Into two trucks. What are the answer comes? For again one more small truck, it should be only 2 months, right? 7,500 into 2 months into one truck. Yeah, can anyone tell me the answers? Yeah, please. Venkya Garotleda. Yeah, fast. Yeah, Likita, come on. 7,500 into 12 into 4 tons. How much?
3,60,000.
3,60,000. Very good. Second one. 1,000 into 16 tons. 16,000.
Yes,
into 5 months. Into 2 trucks.
32,000.
32,000?
10.
What ton?
10.
Try again. 1,000 into 16 tons into 5 into 2.
1,60,000.
Very good, sir. This one? 7,500 into 2 into 1 truck. How much, sir?
15,000.
Therefore, how much is your presumptive income? How much is your presumptive income?
5,35,000.
Correct, huh? Can I rely on your answer?
Yes, sir.
5 lakh?
35,000.
Yeah, check the answers once, everyone. Because it's said by Anudeep. One should cross verify. It is 7,500 into 12 months into 4 trucks. Second one, 1,000 into 16 tons, 16,000 into 5 months into 2 trucks. Check the answers, please. Is it correct?
Yes, sir.
Correct? Chalo, this is the presumptive income. Am I clear? Chalo, shall we move? I hope you got some idea now. See, if you observe, even part of the month is taken as what, sir? Full month, 0.1. For big trucks, we simply see the tons capacity, right?
Yes, sir.
You may get a doubt. Sir, if the vehicle is around 15,442 kg, then what will happen? No one asked the doubt. If the vehicle is 15,442 kgs, see, no one prepares the trucks rounding off, na? The practical life may, this will never come in your RC. Either it would be 15 or it would be what, sir? 16. Getting or not, sir?
Yes, sir.
Aise tons dikhega aapko. It will be never like 15,442 kg. RC me dekho, you will get the answer. Get, na? That what most of the people says. Even your ICA book also, if I am not wrong, partial weight is not even given in any problem. So the difficulty should not come in your exam. So for small trucks, the answer is how much? 7,500 per truck, per month basis. For big trucks, it is on the tonnage capacity you compute the income. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Shall we move? Chalo, give the heading. Other points, this was point number one. Point number two. other points. Point one is point number two. Shall we move, sir?
Yes, sir.
Right. All deductions, same points. All deductions under section 80C. No. All deductions under section 30 to 37(1) are deemed to have been allowed. All deductions under section 30 to 37(1) are deemed to have been allowed. Very good. Note point number 3. One can claim benefit of set off and carry forward. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
One can claim benefit of set off and carry forward. And also, one can claim benefit of set off and carry forward and also ATC to ATU. ATC to ATU. Le sakte ho aap. Set off bhi le sakte ho. ATC to ATU bhi le sakte ho. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Next point. Point number? 4. No relaxation from advance tax. See, completely different point. No relaxation from advance tax. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Next, point number 5. Point number 5. If SSC complies with 44AE, if SSC complies with 44AE, no books, no audit. I hope you are understanding.
Yes, sir.
No books, no audit. Next point. Point number 6. If SSC do not comply with 44A, matlab we want to declare income lower than this, right?
Yes, sir.
If SSC do not comply with 44A, down arrow, mandatory books, mandatory audit. Aise kaise, sir? Aise hai. Mandatory books, mandatory audit. Irrespective of total income.
Yes, sir.
I hope you are understanding the difference in the point.
Yes, sir.
Mandatory books, mandatory audit. Irrespective of total income. Government says, we don't really bother how much is your income. You need to maintain books of accounts and get the same what, sir? Audited by a chartered accountant. Even if your total income is negative, or even if your total income is nil, does not really bother. You need to maintain books of accounts, get the same what, sir? Audited. Shall I move?
Yes, sir.
Next, point number?
Seven.
No lock-in period of 5 years. Aisa kuch bhi nahi hai. So 1 year you can opt in, next year you can opt out. Nothing like that. No lock-in period of how many years?
5 years.
5 years. No lock-in period of 5 years. As applicable in 44AD. Hai na bhai? 44AD mein wo condition hai. Yahan pe wo condition hi nahi hai. Done na?
Yes, sir.
So these are your 3 presumptive income sections. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
Please read once. So we have done with 3 sections which are really independent of each other. As well as they are independent of complete BP chapter.
Yes,
44AD, 44ADA and 44AE. Tino section ekdam independent hai. Am I clear?
Yes,
one small information to you. Have a look, sir. See, for transporters, right now, you will find 3 relaxation under the Income Tax Act. You should remember, yehi padhengi bilke nahi hai, sab kuch padhna hai. For transporters, there are 3 relaxations given under the Income Tax Act. One, what you have learned just now, 44AE section is given to them, saying that if you are in the business of transportation of goods through goods carriages, then no problem, you can comply with 44AE. No need to maintain books of accounts, no need to get them audited. The turnover may be in crores or rupees also. The count is on the vehicle, right? See, one vehicle also, turnover can go up to 30-40 lakhs. Come on. 10 vehicles, matlab, the turnover can go up to 5-6 crores also. Government says, does not really bother. No books, no audit if you comply with 44A. Am I clear?
Yes, sir.
This is one relaxation that you already know. If you remember in 194C, we have learned one point. Whenever you are making payment to transporters, if they own less than 10 goods carriages, less than or equal to 10 goods carriages,
sir,
while making payment to them, there is no TDS. So transporters will receive entire money without TDS. Second relaxation. Matlab in 194C, there is no TDS on what payment? Transport payment. subject to condition, the number of trucks should not exceed how much, sir? 10. And they should give a application, they should give a valid what, sir? PAN.
Valid PAN.
Valid PAN is mandatory. Matlab, even if I am making 40 lakhs payment to transporter, there is not even single rupee what, sir? TDS. Third point, if you are not aware, let me tell you, sir. See, generally there is a section called 40A3. You may not be aware of it. 40A3 says what, you know? Whenever you make payment to someone, the payment should not exceed 10,000 in cash. If you make any payment exceeding 10,000 in cash, then excess amount would be disallowed. But for transporters, you can make the payment up to 35,000 in cash. Not 35,000 the cash use kar sakte aap. So three relaxation exclusively given for transporters, 44A, no TDS when they receive the payment. Third, they can receive how much payment in cash? 35,000. The one transportation bill is 25,000. We can pay in cash, nothing wrong. Unko check dena, wo sab zarurat nahi hai. Government says 35,000 the cash pay karo. By chance, if you pay more than 35,000, entire cash portion would be disallowed. Am I clear with these 3 points?
Yes,
right? They close up once. Will you note this somewhere?
Yes.
Please note. Three special points on transporters. Point number A. Presumptive income section. Hyphen 44A. Yes or no? Unke liye hai na exclusively. Next, B. Payment can be received by transporters. Under section 194C without TDS. TDS ki zarurat hi nahi hai. Without TDS. Last one. Cash payment can be made to transporters up to
35,000.
Cash payment can be made to transporters up to 35,000. Full stop. There will be no disallowance. Under section 40A3, see the section and write carefully. There will be no disallowance. Under section what, sir? 40A3. Am I clear?
Yes,